Hi everyone, welcome to Irish Crochet Lace, and in today's tutorial we're gonna make the DMC Irish Book of the Book of Irish Crochet Lace. That would be page 11, figure 20. That's called the sixth wheel. It's quite a tricky one, so let's get started. Okay, so the motif itself takes about 2 hours to make, so I've got this template ready and we've got finally got the cat in the camera. Okay, so I've done this in the movie. I will make just the two leaves, but this is just generally what you should get. Okay, so at the moment I just need a size 50 thread, and to make the central ring I wrap the thread around the crochet hook handle like this, something about 10 times. I carefully slide it off so it doesn't get mixed. Insert the hook and to the chain. Now I have to make 18 stitches around the circle, around the ring. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 and 18. Do the slip stitch. The problem in the book that the pattern itself is confusing for both British and American, just because it's using single crochet as a double crochet, but at the same time it uses treble as a treble in British. So it's getting very confusing when you're working on this. Anyway, we do the five chains and we make the treble. You can do it on the back side of the stitch or the front one, doesn't matter. Do two chains. So this is the central solar part of the element. This one, and so we've got the first five chains. They act as the one treble and two chains. So now we have to repeat the set of treble and two doubles 17 times. We got two and one, two chain and the treble. Again, I'm talking in British terms, so that would be double for American. Now I have to count. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 2, 4, 6. So there's just two more to go. So we've done the two chains, and we have to locate the third chain over here and do the slip stitch. And one chain. Okay, I prefer to keep the, if you like to keep the set this ring on the face on the right side, turn your work. If you like this part, just like this, just keep working like this. So we do one chain and into the under the next two chains we do one double crochet. One double crochet into the treble, two under the chains, and one into treble, and one under the chain. Turn the work, and since I'll be working on this, just one second, and that's right. You work with on the back side of the stitch. Make five chains, five doubles into each stitch. That's 3, 4, and 5. And to the last stitch, the one that was made with chain, you make two doubles. Now we do one chain up. And again we do the doubles into each stitch, one stitch at a time, into the back side of the stitch. So you have this nice little ridge going in front. Two, three, four. 5, 6, and we got to make 2 into the last stitch, 2 doubles into the last, 1 chain up, you turn the work, and you make 1, 2, and 3 stitches. Okay, now comes the most difficult part. I have to get more light. You do the yarn over and you pick up the central front side of the stitch, and we'll be making 4 trebles into the same stitch and into the same with the same top. So we'll make 1 treble, but don't finish it, leave it as it is. So we've got 2 stitches. Again we do the yarn over and into the same stitch in the bottom row okay. That's the most trickiest part, and that's why I understand why this motif have not been used a lot, because it's really annoying to make. You can see that slides through the thread itself. That's the most difficult part of the element. You have to twist your hook a little bit so it gets through the yarn over, doesn't slide. Okay, we've got two stitches here now, well, three stitches. We've got two more to go, two more trebles. That's two, and the last one. Remember, that's all done down into the same stitch at the bottom, and we work through all the five stitches together. Now on the back side, we skip one stitch here and we work with double into the next. So we'll make three and into this one we make two doubles. Turn again, skip the first and work double crochet all over. So over here we should have something like 8 or 9 stitches. Let me count to 4, 6. Okay, that's 9. And one more. Turn the work. And again, we do the one double. And we do this little thing over again with both. In Russian we call it popcorn stitch, and again we pick up the thread from two rows below, three rows below. We do the treble but don't finish it. Again, pick up the stitch into the same, that's two, number three and number four, all done into the same little loop, the back side of the stitch. So it's the second stitch over here from the edge. We skip one stitch here on the back side where it should be connected, and over here we make next five doubles. It's one, two, three, four, and five. And again, we have to make this popcorn again. So over here, I don't know if you can see that. Just the same row that we did the first popcorn. And we make again one treble. Don't finish it. Next. Two. Four stitches. We got five, got four trebles and the working stitch, so it's got five stitches. We work them all together. We skip the one behind, the stitch behind, one DC into the next and two DC into the edge. Just one second. That's one and two. Again, we turn the work. Yeah, lots of we do one chain. Already done that. So the roll starts with chain and then doubles. That's the wrong side of the petal. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Eight, nine, and we'll make two doubles into the corner. Again, we do one chain, we turn the work, and we continue, we'll make five doubles. Two, three, five. Actually, I think I've done something wrong here. Maybe I skipped too much. Yes. I do one, two, three, four, and five. Again, we do the yarn over, and this time we insert the hook just right between these popcorns here. Probably this way is better. So insert it into this little ridge. And again, four trebles together. Four, just to make sure you got five stitches. Work them all together. Skip one stitch and make five doubles. One, two, three, four, and five. Now at this point, we bind off, we cut the extra thread, something about 10 centimeters, and we close the work. So we've got a petal like this. And now we have to start the second one, which is we make the loop. And working from the wrong side to the left of the motif, we keep that one free, insert the hook into the next one. We've got one treble that is free, and we add the working thread. Do one chain, one double under the chain, use the spare end as a padding cord, secure it inside the motif. Two, again we do two doubles here under the chain, one into treble, one under the chain, one chain. And so we repeat the leaf itself. So we start from the wrong side of the motif and we get it to the right one. And again, working the back side of the stitch, we do doubles. Two, three, four, five, and into this one. Make two doubles. Two, one chain up, and so it goes like this. You just repeat the pattern of the petal. Two, three, four, five, six, and to the last one we'll make two doubles. And again, I'm gonna show you this popcorn stitch. So we skip, we make three doubles here. One, two, three. Just remember that at the end of each row you add one more stitch. So the last stitches I made two into the same stitch. Do the yarn over, and in the middle one, into the middle stitch, do the treble one. That's one, into the same stitch over here, treble two, treble three, and treble four, all are made into the same stitch, and one off, so you get this little, it starts at the same stitch and ends at the same stitch, but in the middle there are four trebles. We skip one and we make it's one, two, three, and four. Here, and so it goes like this. You have to make six petals, so you will end up with something like this, six petals. And once you finish the leaf, you can remove this thread. Actually, you can remove it now, so it will be no longer used. So anyway, you will have too many ends to deal with this element. Okay, so you can continue working on petals, and I'll switch off the camera and I'll finish this element and we'll be back to the padding cord. Just before I start working with the padding cord, just a small reminder. So you've got these two petals done, you turn the work to the back side, and you start your next petal over here to the left. So from the front side, your petal will be going from the right side. Front and right, back and left. Okay, so I've done this little flower here, and I folded the padding cord into two. This is size 10 thread I'm using for the padding cord, and I folded it twice, and using the working thread, which is already has the slip stitch on the edge, on the top, I insert the hook into this treble that was left intact. And one second, yeah, that's right. So we do have to sort out all this mess with the threads, and I found this center of the padding cord. I place it over the treble and insert the hook inside the loop. This is to secure the thread inside the motif. And we do the slip stitch through. And one chain. So now working with the padding cord and the spare end as a padding cord over the edge of the motif, we make 7 doubles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 to the top one. Now we have to make 11 stitches into the back side of the stitch and the padding cord. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Actually, I've done one extra here. I don't know why, but I did. So it goes like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Six, 7, 8, nine, 10, and 11. And this, we add this little thread to this padding cord bundle. At this point, we can remove the thread that was added in the beginning, this little spare end, and we remove that. That's the one that we started from the bottom. So it's fixed inside this petal, and we pick up the next one and we add it to the bundle. So we have to make another 7 doubles going down, and that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. One into the spare treble that we haven't used at the bottom. And again, we go up 7 stitches over the padding cord. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And over here we have to make 4 chains, 3 and 4, and do the slip stitch into this corner over here. Do the slip stitch, 1 chain, we turn and work in the following pattern. We do the 3 DC, 3, 2, one pico. I can make three. I prefer to make it four. It looks nicer. Well, from my point of view, you can make three chain pico. Again, we do three trebles. Three. Make another pico. And two doubles. You want to stretch the petal, and we're going back to the second petal, and we make again, we make 11 doubles to the back side of the stitch. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, and 11 into the fasten stitch. Okay. Again, we separate the fine thread that was left from the previous petal. We cut it off and we join this spare end to the padding cord bundle. And again, we continue. So we've done two petals. I'll show you the rest. Okay, so we'll make seven stitches here to the bottom. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. Can we do one double into the treble base like this? Again, seven stitches up. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. And again, we set the padding cord aside, make four chains. One, two, three, and four. We turn the work and we pick up the corner stitch over here. The last one of the 11th, do the slip stitch, one chain, and again the set of three doubles, one pico, it's nice to have all these little elements and motifs. So you can always combine them. You have two or three elements and you can make the top using the Roslier squares. This is what I probably do with this, all these samples. I got the base for the top almost done. And hopefully on summer I'll have some time to finish this new top. Three and four. And two doubles. So of course there will be a tutorial. And again, we pick up the padding cord, And we're working on the back side of the stitch. We'll make 11 doubles. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. 10 and 11. Again, we replace the padding, the fine thread in the padding cord. It's one from the previous petal. It's a short one. I clip it off. And I add this one, whisper end, to the bundle. So it goes like this. And I'll probably switch off the camera now until I finish this list and I come to the last one. So I'll be back in a couple of seconds. Okay, so I've almost finished. We've got one more petal left. And at this point, we already have to start thinking about the securing the padding cord. So I measure it to the bottom. Over here, just where it started. And I pull it through. Grab the bigger hook. It's 1 millimeter size. And it's easier to pick up the threads. So I pull them through. Just like in previous videos, just like I showed to secure the threads, the padding cord. We will fold it twice like this to the height of the petal. And we will leave this thread so far on the side. We'll get it to, we'll secure it once we get to that point. And I continue working with the working thread. We've got a little tiny thread left from the previous petal, still using it as a padding cord. And I guess that would be a normal height for me. And we'll work with 11 doubles, just like we would do on a single pair of padding cord. Two, three, four, five, six, sorry, seven, eight, nine. Just make sure that all the padding cords are on the right, on the wrong side, are in place. Nine, 10, and 11. Now we've got the short one cast out and trim away. Now we have to make this little jump thing between the petals. So from this point, we obviously we cannot go back here, and we do the three, four chains into the corner here, turn the work and work as usual with three trebles, one pico, three trebles, one pico, two trebles and the slip stitch. Turn the work, and over here, that's the trickiest part. We continue over the padding cord. It's a bit difficult to make, but we will try it. The spare end from the leaf, from the petal, is already in the padding cord. And over here we have to make 7 more stitches. That's why you don't see that element too often. It's a bit, requires a bit of 3D orientation and very thin fingers to get through. 3, 4. Just make sure you don't pick up anything else extra. 6 and 7, and to make just 2 more stitches here to secure the loop of the padding cord. 1 and the slip stitch here. So the element is finished. I can cut the working thread. Pull the motif to the right size. It needs to be steamed, steam ironed. And on the wrong side, you remove the padding cord and the spare end. So the only thing you have to secure is this final thread, and this is the wheel number 6 from DMC library. So stay tuned, subscribe, and to get the first notifications about the new tutorials, you might click on the bottom of this video. On the right side there will be the bell sign. If you click on that, you'll get notifications, so as soon as I get the video published, you'll be informed about it. Okay, so that's it for today. See you later. Bye.